In this video, we're going to take a look at the offset effect in Stylism by Astute Graphics. Here I've got some artwork selected. I'm going to come over here to the Stylism panel. This button right here is for the offset effect. When I click on it once, it applies the offset to my selected artwork. When I come over here to the Appearance panel, you'll see it has the offset effect right here at the bottom of the stack. And when I click on it, this panel comes up. So basically, all we're doing is applying the live effects that ship native with Adobe Illustrator. I'll hit Cancel to get out of that. And if you want to make some changes to your offset effect, all you have to do is click on this annotation and drag it out towards the right. And now you see I've increased this offset. If I bring it towards the left, you see I'm decreasing the offset. I could even come over here to a negative offset. And if I continue on after a specific point, it actually just maxes out. It basically just turned inside out or ate itself, however you want to look at it. So when I click on this annotation and bring it back, you see now it's starting to make those changes again for me. So I'll just leave it right around here, and that looks good to me. So I've been using this slider, just going back and forth with this to make changes. But sometimes this might move a little bit too fast for the kind of changes you want to make. So as I'm making changes here, I'll hold down the Command key, and now you see my slider's really slowed down a lot. This is going to allow me to make more precise edits. Once I release the Command key, you see things speed up again. All right, I'll leave it right here. Now, I could double-click on this annotation, and it'll bring up this offset path. And in here, I could enter in a specific value, and you'll see it updated here on my artwork. Now, because this is a live effect, I could make changes to my artwork, and you'll see the effect is going to update with it. So I'm going to switch this over to a star, and you see the offset is still keeping up with me. Let me hide this guy and then bring up the Stylism panel. All right, so now that I have this up, let me activate the Stylism tool. And here I want to show you we actually have different kind of corners we could apply using this drop-down menu. By default, it's set to miter, but we could switch over to a round corner. We can switch it over to a bevel corner as well. I'm going to come back over here and just switch it over to a miter join. And the only thing we don't have access to right here in Stylism is going to be your miter limit. So let me come over here to the Appearance panel. I'll find the effect. And you'll see right here I have this section where I could deal with the miter limit. Let me hit preview. And right now the miter limit's set to 4, so I'm seeing these nice sharp corners right here. But if I reduce that limit, you see because of the reduction, I've actually cut off these spikes. So let me hit cancel. That's going to get me out of that. And I'll hide this Appearance panel. Next is come over here, and we've been dealing with this basic shape, but we could actually come over here and start applying this effect to live text. So I have this guy selected, come back over here to the Stylism panel, and I'll click on the offset path. You see again, it's added this offset path right to this text. So if we take a look at it here in the Appearance panel, again, these are just basic live effects, so we could add them to our fill. We could even make copies of them here in the Appearance panel. I'm going to change the color of my fill, because now while I have this guy targeted, I'm going to reduce that offset, and now I have this cool effect here. Now, the true power comes that this is live text. So let me just come in here and change this to Astute Graphics. And then accept that change. And you see, I've updated my text, but all my effects are still intact. So that's really cool. All right, I'm going to come over here to the star. Now, this last tip is going to be for the power users out there. Let me make a change to my artwork real quick and just round off these corners. So now that I've made this change to my artwork, I just wanted to get these corners rounded off. I'm going to come over here and activate my Stylism tool, and then hover over this annotation here. When I hold down the Alt key, you see the information next to my cursor changes. It says Move Offset Annotation. When I click and drag, I'm going to bring it over here to this path, and as soon as it collides, you see it's actually going to start colliding and rotating along this path. It's actually also snapping at these anchor points. So I'm going to leave it right here and then release. This is really cool. This is going to give me a lot more power over this and more of an artistic control over this. So when I click and drag, let's say I want it to offset all the way out to this distance. When I release, you see it catches up to where my cursor was. I'll come back over here and I'm going to click once on this slider. And now you see the offset has been reduced to where I had my cursor. And there you have it, folks. That's how you use the offset effect in Stylism by Astute Graphics.